With the new year approaching, are you starting to ponder your 2020 credit card strategy like I am? Well, in this video, we're going to be taking a look at 5 credit cards that will be in my wallet for the year ahead. Hey everyone, this is Kyle from Money at 30. On this channel, we look at personal finance from a millennial perspective, including credit card reviews like this one. As I've noted on this channel before, after a rough patch in my 20s, I swore off credit cards for several years. However, after learning that my credit had rebounded since those days, I've spent the past couple of years using plastic to my advantage and have continued to evolve my credit card strategy. With that in mind, I thought I'd share a look at the 5 main credit cards I'll be using throughout 2020 in order to maximize my rewards. The first card I'll be keeping in my wallet for 2020 also happens to be one of my newer ones, and that is the Platinum card by American Express. After years of avoiding annual fee cards, I made one major exception a few months ago by opting for the Platinum card from American Express. At $550, the charge card is certainly not cheap, but the perks on travel really appealed to me, including airline incidental credits, Uber credits, 5x points on certain flights and hotel bookings, and of course airline lounge access. Specifically, what put the Platinum over the top for me was that it allows you access to Delta's SkyClub when you're flying that airline, which is a huge perk to me as a primarily Delta flyer. Meanwhile, I've also already found value in the Hilton and Marriott Gold status that come with the card, as well as the various Amex offers available to cardholders. Of course, while I'm excited about the possibilities of the Amex membership rewards points and have found the steep annual fee to be worth it, as you'll see, I'll still be maintaining a mostly cash back setup for 2020 and don't have any plans to add other annual fee cards to my wallet just yet. Next up is a somewhat controversial card that I'll be specifically keeping in my digital wallet, the Apple Card. Among credit card enthusiasts, the Apple Card has been a bit of a running joke. That's likely because the card has no sign-up bonus and a relatively weak reward structure. Still, between the growing list of retailers offering 3% when you use your Apple Card and the 2% back on Apple Pay purchases category, I've actually found that the card can be useful. On top of that, the company has continued to improve the offering by upping the daily cash you earn on Apple purchases to 6% for a limited time and rolling out interest-free iPhone financing via the card as well. So while it may have its flaws, I'm still glad to have it available to me. Now for a card my wife and I added to our mix just a couple of weeks ago, the Capital One Saver One. With Barclays recently announcing major changes to my beloved Uber Visa card that render it all but useless to me, my wife and I sought to find a suitable replacement. After much consideration, we landed on the Saver One card from Capital One, mostly because of the 3% it offers on dining and entertainment. That second category is actually quite important, since we frequently visit the Disney theme parks. In fact, it helps plug one hole we noticed where some of the restaurants in Disneyland Paris were coding as an amusement park instead of dining. Speaking of international travel, another way in which the Saver One is taking over for the Uber Visa is that it has no foreign transaction fees. And with it being a MasterCard, its acceptance overseas is quite strong. By the way, in case you were wondering, the reason we went with the Saver One over the regular Saver card that offers 4% in the same key categories is because, for one, that card has a $95 annual fee, although it is waived for the first year. Also playing a role in our decision were the sign-up bonuses, with the Saver One's $150 after a $500 spend proving more attractive than the Saver's $300 after a $3,000 spend. With that initial threshold already met, it's fairly safe to say I'm pretty pleased with our choice. From my newest card to one of my oldest, I'll also be keeping my Discover It card around in 2020. As I assume most people with the Discover It card will tell you, the best feature of this card is the 5% rotating quarterly categories it offers. These have been great ever since I first got the card, and the 2020 calendar looks strong as well, especially the 5% on dining that lasts from July to September, and the much-loved Amazon category that closes out the year. There are a few other perks I also appreciate about my Discover It card, but for now, I think that's enough said. Finally, there's also our good old PNC Everyday Rewards card, although it doesn't seem that this one's still open to new applicants. For the sake of completion, I also wanted to mention that we still regularly use my wife's PNC Everyday Rewards card that she's had for several years. So long, in fact, that it seems that this card is no longer offered. Still, we regularly make use of this card for its 4% back on gas and 2% back on groceries. You may know that the latter category actually matches what the Saver One offers, but since you need to reach $100 in rewards before you can cash out on PNC, it makes more sense to put at least a couple of spend categories on this card instead. Hopefully this gets you thinking about your credit card strategy for the new year, but for more on each of these cards, I'll have a link to my article on direnews.com in the description box down below. Also, if you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button, leave a comment, and be sure to subscribe because we have new videos every week. So thanks again for watching, and I will see you next time here on Money at 30.